Welcome back to Coeur, Idaho. I'm Ms. World Traveler Kerry Damiano, and I happen to be here on a beautiful fall day when it's just lovely to be here on the main street Sherman Avenue for a day of shopping. However, this is North Idaho and winter is coming. Goodness for the leather works, purveyors of sheepskin and leather goods, where there is plenty to keep you warm and toasty on cold winter days. Upon entering, you are greeted with homey earth tones, the aromatic scent of fresh cut wood, and friendly conversation with owner Mark Rogers.
So, but what makes us special is this line of slippers that we've developed over, a quarter century. And these are all made out of the finest materials available today, American made, all of them. These are sheepskin hides.
And where do you get your sheepskin?
Well, it's from San Antonio, Texas, one of the last tanneries.
Oh, really?
And our design comes apart and is washable and replaceable when it wears out. This is what makes our design so superior, is that this part of a slipper almost never wears out.
Okay, it's even if it gets wet. Wear.
It's washable.
Oh, fantastic, okay.
This is, ours are.
Great.
So we make them in different kinds of flavors. They all have the same top, which you can wear up or flip down.
Mm-hmm.
But people like different kinds of bottoms on them. So,
this one has a suede.
Correct.
Bottom.
Suede leather bottom with a removable kind of a stiff liner on the inside, and that gives it some body.
Okay.
We offer people who are in wheelchairs, people who have foot issues. This is medical sheepskin in here, and it's the softest, most comfortable thing you will ever put on your foot.
Wow.
Not designed for outdoors.
Okay.
Indoors only. It has the suede bottom.
Okay, but it's soft on the inside.
So soft that you can't hurt someone putting that on. You know, that it's what you need for any foot issues, or just for the softest curling up on the couch kind of a slipper.
Mm-hmm.
This is it. That's our signature items, and then we do something fun by our princess line has this amazing fur on top.
Love it.
Makes you want.
And I especially like the black one with a little bit of the dark tipped
with the tip
fur. Oh, love that.
And they're the same removable liners or and two different kinds of soles.
Great.
So. Yeah.
Well, now Mark, you told me about some of the. This is your main line. This is. What you specialize in.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to go back a little further because I read about you that you used to live in a teepee, and you and your wife, you got married in 1980 and you were living off the grid. So were you guys hippies?
Were we hippies?
Yeah. Are you going to go ask your wife if you're hippies?
No.
You were hippies?
No. I'm going to show you a photograph right over here of us in the day, and that will answer all questions.
Okay.
We need to look at this. This is Mary and I when we got married.
I love
it. Were we hippies?
You were hippies.
That was us when we got married.
Wow. You spread it out a little because hippies was more like 60s and 70s, was it?
Right.
And this was in 1980s, so you were just hanging on tight to the lifestyle.
Yeah, and you know, it's still been called hippies. That's fine because, you know, it was. But then by the time of our wedding, it was mostly about going back to the land and going organic and going alternative energy. And trying to be part of the solution instead of part of the problem.
And it wasn't that much later, 1982, when you started this business. So was that kind of an offshoot then of this desire to have things a little more from a simpler time?
Well, it was. And it was the fact that the fellow who made us our wedding ceremonial buckskins took us under his wing and kind of liked us, took a shine to us, and offered that if we wanted to ever, that we seemed to have what it would take to be leather workers around. But he agreed to apprentice us and let us, he trained us first to make moccasins. And so that we could, we made our moccasins for our wedding clothes there. And then that, after he saw that we kind of had an interest in that and wanted to do it, he offered to let us apprentice. We went and worked. He had a leather business in Colorado and got us going.
Yeah. So what about the leather speaks to you? Is it the feel of it, the smell of it, how it works? What is it?
Well, it's, to me, it's heritage. It's a string that goes back to our ancestors for a million years. I'm fascinated by, you know, what people did with leather, like the Native Americans, an entire lodge out of buffalo hides, you know, that's fascinating to me. But
I also see that you are training up some of the younger generation right here in your studio to learn. So why don't we go back and see a little demonstration? You can kind of explain some of the things that are going on.
Sure. Yeah. You to take the two pieces, stick them fur to fur side together, and then be able to attach them, and with a nice clean seam that doesn't have any fur sticking out of it.
Yeah, that makes sense, because you're right. It seems like some of the fur would pop up, and then you're trying to clean it out, and
well,
it would
just
be a mess.
Ugly.
Yeah. That too.
But yeah, the fur gets put to the inside, and the seam wraps around it and holds it all together so that there's no furry stuff sticking out and it's bound together. And that's the first stage of assembly. Then all the seams are reinforced on another machine just to make sure they're strong. But that's the machine that'll put them together so that we can do the rest of it.
What's next for you? New products, retirement, sailing off into the sunset.
Well,
I mean, are you just hitting your stride, or?
Well, no. I'm not running on all cylinders anymore. I've been doing this now 40 years, so I'm kind of like, okay, I could back away, you know, which is my focus now. Is trying to create the formula, the pattern, the mold, the technique, all the things, put them all in place so that someone young can come in with more energy than I have these days, and I'll be able to bring it to life, and thus preserving the whole leather heritage. Yeah.
Well, thank you, Mark. Thank you for letting us into the inner sanctum and showing us some of the wonderful things that you're doing. And I love your passion for leather itself, but also for passing it on. So
I
really appreciate it.
I mean, it'd be nice if it didn't die.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Like the rest of us, right?
When you're in Coeur d'Alene, be sure to stop by the Leatherworks, say hi to Mark, and pick up a pair of soft, warm slippers. Next week, I'll introduce you to two of the most fashionable ladies in town. You won't want to miss it.